जो बायो मॉलिक्यूल से डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. सो गिवन बिलो इज ए ग्राफ शोइंग द कन्वर्शन ऑफ ए सबस्ट्रेट इनटू ए प्रोडक्ट. ठीक है, सबस्ट्रेट इनटू प्रोडक्ट बाय एन एंजाइम इन व्हिच वन ऑफ द फोर ऑप्शन ए टू डी, वन ऑफ द फोर ऑप्शन ए टू डी द कंपोनेंट ऑफ ए रिएक्शन लेवल level A, B, C and D identified correctly, right? Now you have to, what you have to do here, you have to identify the graph. So first is the, you all know, enzyme substrate, enzyme combines with substrate, enzyme plus substrate, it's from ES complex, enzyme substrate complex, and then it's from enzyme plus product, E plus P, right? So first of all, here see that the there is a option given the transition state. Transition state means jekhane ES complex formation, enzyme substrate complex formation, it's a transition state, that's ES complex formation. And transition state actually basically unstable, it's not a, because it's have to produce product, right? So first graph, see that this is a this A, this graph D and C. So I have told you that enzyme lowers the activation energy of a biochemical reaction, right? So enzyme actually, so D, see that option A, A is your transition state. Transition state is actually ES complex. Now here is the product. Now here is the enzyme plus substrate. Enzyme combines with substrate. He is the enzyme substrate complex. This is the transition state. Now that the activation energy with activation energy without enzyme, see that D is the activation energy without enzyme, activation energy without enzyme, because now these are activation energy with enzyme. So D will be question number D, the option D, sorry, option D will be your activation energy with enzyme. So C will be activation energy without enzyme, B will be potential energy, and A will be transition state. So option B is the correct answer for this question, right? So next question, next question we'll see, question number 2. Now question number 2, which of the following statement with correct with the reference of enzymes, enzyme reference conta correct, right? Enzymes actually we know that hollow enzyme, hollow means complete enzyme, hollow enzyme means complete enzyme, apoenzyme plus cofactor, apoenzyme plus cofactor together we called as a hollow enzyme. So here cofactor is not given. So cofactor, we know that cofactor is, two types of cofactors are there, cofactors are two type, one is called organic cofactor, organic cofactor, and inorganic cofactor. Organic cofactor is known as coenzyme, and inorganic cofactor is known as metal activator. Organic cofactor is known as coenzyme, inorganic cofactor is known as metal activator, right? So here see that, so cofactor here is given hollow enzyme cofactor, COFAC, acha ekhane ekta T hobe, TOR cofactor. So now see that the hollow enzyme is the apoenzyme plus coenzyme, you can say that, because organic cofactor is called coenzyme, right? So answer will be option A, Now, next question. Now, which of the following statement is incorrect? Right? Which of the following statement is incorrect? Now, you have to find out the incorrect option. Now, first of all, see that competitive inhibitor. Competitive inhibitor does not affect the rate of breakdown of the enzyme substrate complex. Right? First option one. Now, option B is given presence. The presence of competitive inhibitors came decreases for the enzyme substrate. I have told you the formula V0 equal to Vmax into S by Km plus S. Vmax formula is that V0 equal to Vmax into S will be third bracket in the S by Km plus S. S is the substrate concentration. So here you know that in competitive inhibition V0 decrease. Achha, Vmax remains same because here competition occurs between same active site, right? Inhibitor and substrate both are compete for active site. Inhibitor and substrate both compete for active site, right? So here now you know that Km. Now what will be the Km? It's a ratio. A by B ratio. I have told you. Remember in that way. A by B ratio. So if you forgot how will A by B ratio. See, it is a ratio is coming C. Suppose A by B, the product is ratio is C. C is decreasing. You know that C is decreasing, and you also know that A is remain same. So how it will be decreased? If you increase B, now in lower portion Km is there, S substrate concentration both side is there, so it will remain almost same. So Vmax also remains same. So Km should be increased. Then only your ratio will be decreased now. So here is the written Km decreases. So it's not correct. Km should be increased in case of competitive inhibition. So it's not correct option. So here only kids find out the incorrect. But rest of the question, see that why this is correct or not. How now option C, see a competitive inhibitor reacts irreversibly with the enzymes to form an enzyme inhibitor complex. Yes, it's a reversible reaction enzyme because enzyme, if you increase the substrate concentration, then it will be reversible, right? So it's correct option. In competitive inhibitor, the inhibitor molecule is not chemically changed by the enzyme. Yes, it's also correct. Competitive inhibitor does not affect the rate of breakdown of the enzyme substrate complex. So answer will be your option B. It will be increased. Now, next question. Question number four. Which of the following is a non-reducing sugar? Non-reducing sugars is actually maltose. Maltose is a reducing sugar. Lactose is a reducing sugar. Ribose, 5-phosphate is a reducing sugar. Only the sucrose is a non-reducing sugar, and that's why plant transport in the forms of sucrose. Sucrose form plant transport. Plant actually transported materials photosynthate not in the forms of glucose. It transport in the forms of sucrose. As sucrose is a non-reducing sugar, it do not contain free aldehyde and keto group. Right. So answer will be option B. Next question. Now, DAS are the most abundant in the living world. Living world are the most abundant molecules. Most abundant in plants is known as Rubisco. Rubisco, you will see in the Kelvin cycle. Kelvin cycle, it's fixed carbon dioxide, RUBP plus CO2. In presence of Rubisco, enzyme, it will convert into PGA or 3-phosphoglyceric acid, right? So in Rubisco is the plant, and collagen in case of animals is the most abundant component. Now next is so now match the column: nitrogen base, nucleoside, nucleotide, and nucleic acid. See that nucleic acid, when you call nucleic acid basically two type of nucleic acid are there, DNA and RNA, right? So nucleic acid should be RNA first of all. And now nitrogen base, you know that already ATGC and U are the nitrogen base: adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine, and uracil. Instead of thymine, RNA have uracil, right? Now coming to the nucleotide and nucleoside. Nucleotide is nitrogen base, nucleotide is nitrogen base plus pentose sugar plus phosphate added means it's going to be acidic, right? So you can write it like thymine here you can write it as a thymidylic acid, because phosphate present, that you can write it's a nucleotide. Thymidylic acid, it's a nucleotide. And nucleoside is, it's a cytidine, because nucleoside is nitrogen base pentose sugar. Nucleoside is nitrogen base plus pentose sugar, that's we call it as a nucleoside. As it is lack phosphate, so that's why it's not acid is added. If it is a phosphate is present, then it will be acid, right? So the thymidylic acid, cytidine here is a nucleoside, and cytidylic acid will be nucleotide. Acid term is added, then it will be nucleotide, because with presence of phosphate in nucleoside, phosphate is absent, that's why it's a cytidine. So cytidine will be nucleoside and nucleotide will be thymidylic. So answer will be option matching A4B3C2D1, right? So answer will be option C. Next question, question number 7. Now, transition state of the structure form. During enzyme substrate complex reaction, I have to transition state is a transient, because it's have to, yes, complex is a transient and unstable, because it's have to produce product. If it's a stable, then it will never produce product, right? So it's a transient and unstable, right? Enzyme substrate reaction, if it enzyme reacts with substrate, enzyme substrate complex form, it's a transient reaction. Then enzyme plus product is a product, as it is a product is forming, so it should be transient and unstable. So answer will be option C. Now another here is a macromolecule chitin. You know that it's a homopolysaccharide. So chitin, the phosphorus containing polysaccharide, no, chitin is a made up of N-acetyl glucosamine. Chitin er modhe ki thake, N-acetyl glucosamine. N-acetyl glucosamine is a nitrogen containing polysaccharide. Chitin is a nitrogen containing polysaccharide. It's have a N-acetyl D-glucosamine residue joined by N-acetyl chitin contain N-acetyl D-glucosamine residue. N-acetyl डी ग्लूकोसामाइन, रेसिड्यू जॉइन बाय बीटा 1,4 ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड, बीटा 1,4 ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड, बीटा 1,4 ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड. सो आंसर विल बी डी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. So in a curve, it's a curve is given. Now you have to identify the x-axis and y-axis, right? X-axis and y-axis. So if you we have seen that, we have told you that, say if it is a enzyme activity versus this graph was enzyme activity. If you plot the y-axis enzyme activity and x-axis if it is a temperature or pH, then this will be the graph, because you know that there is a optimum temperature. Is there in which enzyme activity is maximum, after which enzyme activity decreases, or maximum pH or optimum pH, not maximum, optimum pH at which the enzyme activity is maximum. That is, so x-axis will be temperature and enzyme activity. Now if you plot the x-axis in substrate concentration versus enzyme activity, you will get the hyperbolic curve. Substrate concentration versus enzyme activity. If you plot x-axis substrate concentration, then y-axis, these are called, you will get hyperbolic curve, right? In that way, enzyme activity versus, if you plot C, x-axis enzyme activity and temperature, this will not be enzyme activity and pH, x-axis enzyme activity. So x-axis will be either temperature, x-axis will be either temperature or pH. Temperature or pH. Temperature or pH. And y-axis will be your enzyme activity. Y-axis will be enzyme activity and x-axis will be temperature and pH. Now, next question. See that which of the following graph describe the correctly. This is a enzyme kinetics graph, same as I have told you. It's a enzyme actually lower the activation energy. How enzyme lowers the activation energy? You all know that enzyme combines this. There is a reaction in the active site with the substrate, and this weak interaction with the substrate and the active site of the enzyme lowers the activation energy. And during that enzyme, without enzyme, the activation energy will be more, right? This much amount of energy is required without enzyme, and this much amount activation energy is required for with enzyme. And it's a exothermic reaction, because energy releasing. So exothermic reaction with the energy A in the presence of enzyme, and B is the absence of enzyme. So it will be option B. So next question. Now see that abrin and GLUT4. GLUT4 is a glucose transporter, right? Abrin is a toxin. It's a natural poison. Abrin is a natural poison. Abrin is a natural poison. Abrin is a natural poison. And another is that GLUT is a glucose transporter. GLUT4. It is a different types of GLUTs are there. GLUT1, GLUT2, GLUT3, GLUT1. Basically GLUT4 is the glucose transporter. GLUT means glucose transporter. Collagen, you all know, present in our skin. It's a protein, intracellular protein. And concanavalin Concanavalin is a type of lectin. Lectin generally binds with carbohydrate. Carbohydrate, right? So now match the option. Abrine is a poison. So first see that abrine, so will be toxin. Now GLUT will be enable glucose transporter. So A5 only one option is given. So A5, B4, C2 and D1. D1 is a concanavalin is a lectin. C intracellular ground, because collagen actually basic in present in our skin is a basic ground substance and it's a matrix protein also, collagen. So answer will be option B. Now next question. What is exhibited by the lower Km value? You know that Km is called Michaelis constant, and Km is inversely proportional to substrate concentration, right? Km inversely proportional to 1 by substrate concentration, right? So if you increase substrate concentration or Km value high, means substrate concentration Km value, actually lower Km value. Now here is lower Km value. Km value is low. That means substrate affinity is high. Lower Km value, it's inversely proportional. So it will be more affinity with substrate. Now, next question. Identify the correct pair of statement. Here is given 5-methyluracil. Thymine is known as 5-methyluracil. It's a correct. Thymine also called as 5-methyluracil. 5-methyluracil. Thymine and uracil is only difference in a methyl group. 5-methyluracil is known as thymine. Another is that the aquaporin is a polypeptide. Aquaporin actually it's a channel protein. That's why it's a polypeptide. Aquaporin, it's a channel protein. Water channel protein is called aquaporin. It's a polypeptide. So these two are correct. Now see that arachidonic acid and palmitic acid. Arachidonic acid is 20 carbon. And palmitic acid have 16 carbon. So arachidonic acid contain more, not less. It will be arachidonic have 20 carbon, palmitic acid has 16 carbon, so it's not correct. Now cellulose contain complex helix. Cellulose is not a complex helix. Cellulose is a type of carbohydrate, it's a polysaccharide, major component in plant. So cellulose. So answer will be A and option D, A and 4. 1 and 4. Now next question. Which of the following given below are correctly represent the basic amino acids? So basic amino acids have, you all know, basic amino acids have extra NH2 group in their side chain. See that here, normal, you have COOH group, normal NH2 group, and there is a COOH group extra. So it's a acidic amino acid. Now see that this is a CH2OH, it's a hydroxyl group containing or OH group containing amino acid. Now here see that only one NH2 group, and there is no, this is not a amino acid. And they see that here there is a NH2 group is there, and extra another NH2 group is here. So it's a basic amino acid. Basic amino acid contain other than the, these are normal chain H, these are side chain NH2 group. So as there is an extra side chain NH2 group, so this will be basic amino acid. So answer will be option B, that is D. Next question. Select the which is the correct in respect to enzyme action. enzyme action, actually your substrate binds with enzyme at its active site. It's a correct option. Acha, enzyme bind with substrate, enzyme substrate complex form. Now addition of lot of succinate does not reverse the inhibition of succinate dehydrogenase to malonate. Acha, succinate to malonate, actually Krebs cycle have a reaction. One is called succinate converted to malonate. When succinate converted to malonate, succinate convert to succinate converted to fumarate, or here the enzyme is required is a succinate dehydrogenase. The enzyme required is succinate. This is a reaction of Krebs cycle. The succinate dehydrogenase is the enzyme. Succinate dehydrogenase enzyme. So succinate dehydrogenase presence ki hai? Now succinate to fumarate. Now malonate acts as a competitive inhibitor. Now competitive inhibitor is a resemble with each other. So if it is a increasing succinate concentration, that is a substrate concentration. This is a substrate. If you increase substrate concentration, the reaction can be reversed. So here is given not reverse. That's why its option is not correct. So a competitive inhibitor, non-competitive inhibitor, inhibitor binds enzyme at the site distinct from at which substrate bind. Yes, inhibitor bind. In case of non-competitive inhibitor, inhibitor always bind in the allosteric site other than the active site. See that it is our active site. Inhibitor binds in the allosteric site. This was non-competitive. These are correct. Malonate is a competitive inhibitor of succinate dehydrogenase. Malonate is a competitive inhibitor of succinate. Malonate compete with succinate dehydrogenase. Right, and here it's substrate succinate and malonate are resemble with each other, right? So next you have almost finished. So